All right. It just has to happen. I believe the YouTube interface has just become kind of stupid. Many years now. So what we need to do is we need to make it a little bit more selective grouping style. So you sign on. It has to be more personalized. Like this is. I am this type of person, these are my interests, and these are the people that I'm attracted to. And so we have to go to that immediately, you know. If I only want artists to watch me, then I only want artists to watch me. I only want them there. I don't want anybody else. And that's the way it goes. If I only want actors or a comedian, if I only want gosh heavens, what if there's a woman who only wants, like, what do you call them, the anchorman on the television show, only them, that's a funny one. But yeah, we have to get this selective. I believe with the selectivity also, it does help the organism human control itself in Gomorrah, doesn't it? It helps them a little bit, you know, it's like, whoa, selectivity. Not all. Yeah, so we're gonna have, you know, back to, this is really just a bonking show. So we're gonna have to think about, well, what are you on about, you know? What are you on about? What is your real intention? You know, what type of person is your attractive? And so we need an attractive list of what's attractive to you. And unfortunately, normally it is like some kind of work profession. What is attractive to you, you know? Like, I only want photographers, you know. That's it. You know, there could be that situation. I only want persons who travel watching me, you know, travel all the time. Who are like perpetual travelers, you know. So we need this, and even make it up as you go. The persons can make it up as they go. We don't have to run the list, the gamut of, like what is that, one of those tax forms, that thinks it has every career and job stated and plated. No, it doesn't have to have that, and it will be the persons organizing it themselves. You know, if they're an idiot and they make it too cryptic and too difficult in a find, well then they won't have very many visitors or watchers. But like I've stated on my site that went up fiddle and then out again, and I don't know if it's going to even stay there. I don't trust it. It may absolutely leave. So I don't know. I did make that art gallery, but like I said there on that site, I want, it has to be artist, it has to be musician or singer, it has to be, you know, poets, or there was other thing, or fictional writer. So see, oh, I'm getting selective, but all of these things in conjunction, and I only want that person and that group of people, persons male, to watch me. And I can even click there and say I want the men only, and I can click there I want the females only. So I really need YouTube to stand and deliver some truity to this experience, because we're just ending out here just with a bunch of dumbified sheep looking at you going, oh well, I clicked on you and subscribed and I don't know why, you know, because what, you're just like in a mental institution and you had access all of a sudden one day to the lookup, and you remembered once in your life there was a Mother Teresa, and then so you found me because I listed my name as Teresa, and you just have a informatica over a cross. No, I don't want this type of visitor. I don't want this type of subscriber. So we definitely have to increase. And with it, YouTube will increase its gains, its gainings. Everybody will be interested in it. It becomes a matchmaking service. It becomes an organization that enriches it. So do you want a richer YouTube, or do you just want it to just be some stupid thing that just people are like, I'll just watch live video because the girls are more naked there. You know what I mean? So we have to increase it more to be... An absolute human experience, where a human can actually contact another human that is interested in, you know, and then YouTube is a worthwhile investment, and actually something that you would actually buy if you were a day trader. So there.